Hey there, and welcome to the Daily Manchester United News Show. Let's dive into today's top stories. Raphael Varane set to leave Manchester United in the summer for Saudi Arabia or Italy. Manchester United centre-back Raphael Varane is set to leave the Old Trafford club in the summer for the Serie A or Saudi Pro League, according to The Sun. The Frenchman, who currently earns £340,000 per week, has recently fallen down the pecking order and has been linked with an exit ahead of the January transfer window. However, Man United manager Erik ten Hag will not allow Varane leave in the winter, as his side could do with having such an experienced and a quality option available as a cover. The former Real Madrid star is the fourth choice centre-back behind Harry Maguire, Johnny Evans and Victor Lindelof, and his days are numbered amid interest from Saudi. The 30-year-old is also keen on moving to the Italian top flight as he admires the league, and Man United will listen to offers in the summer with around £17 to £20 million likely to be enough for them to sell him. The former France international is out of contract in 2026, and the Red Devils know they can still get something valuable if they decide to cash in on him at the end of the campaign. Varane could look to force his way back into the starting 11 at Man United, but it seems Ten Hag is ready to move on and could look to bring in younger options next summer, given the ages of his current centre-backs. Lindelof is 29, Maguire is 30, while Evans is 35, with the injured Lisandro Martinez, who is 25, and 28-year-old Luke Shaw, the only options in the position who are still young. A squad overhaul at centre-back is a must if Man United are serious about challenging for major silverware going forward, and soon-to-be co-owner Sir Jim Ratcliffe will be keen to oversee the needed changes ahead of next season. Varane is unlikely to be the only player who would be leaving in the summer, and most of them could be inadvertently playing for their future at the theatre of dreams in the coming months. Luke Shaw could make long-awaited return for Man United against Everton. The tide may finally be turning for Manchester United and their lengthy injury list. The man claims that United left-back Luke Shaw could finally be available to play against Everton on Sunday when the Premier League season resumes after the latest international break. United have been decimated with fitness problems all season. The injuries continue to mount up, with Lisandro Martinez, Casemiro, Christian Eriksen, Johnny Evans, and possibly Rasmus Hojlund all still on the sidelines for numerous weeks. Youngsters Amad Diallo and Kobbie Mainoo still haven't been able to make an appearance for the first team this season due to ongoing physical issues. Mainoo is on his way back, having played vital roles in youth football this season and recently made the bench against Manchester City. Moreover, the injury curse seemed to have taken two more players during the international break when Marcus Rashford and Andre Onana both had to be subbed off during their respective national teams' victories on Friday night. Luckily, both injuries seemed to be minor and Rashford was already available again for England's next game. Therefore, Luke Shaw returning to action will put a smile on all United fans' faces. The Man reports that Aaron Wan-Bissaka has recovered from a bout of illness to face Everton this week, and Ten Hag may even welcome back Luke Shaw. Sharp eyes will be on training to see if he is present. The English international has not played since the second game of the season in a 2-0 defeat to Tottenham Hotspur at the back end of August. The 28-year-old suffered a muscular injury and had to exit the field of play. Shaw has been an integral part of the Manchester United team over the last few seasons, despite horrific injury problems and moral-sapping clashes with Jose Mourinho at the start of his United career. The left-back has shown his class and importance to the first team in recent years. Man United star Andre Onana hopeful of being fit for Everton game. Manchester United goalkeeper Andre Onana is hopeful of being fit for the Premier League clash against Everton on Sunday evening, the Cameroon international picked up a pelvic injury during the 3-0 win over Mauritius in a World Cup qualifier on Friday. He was taken off in the 80th minute of the game and was subsequently allowed to return to United to undergo further tests. The outcome is yet to be known, but Onana believes he should recover in time for the trip to Goodison Park this weekend. The 27-year-old has played every minute for United since his summer switch from Inter Milan. The 40 million euros rated star had a difficult start to his Red Devils career with goalkeeping errors, but has grown in confidence as the campaign has progressed. Onana was one of the club's best performers after the last international break, and he appears to be getting back to his peak form from his time at Inter. He suffered an untimely injury last week, but it seems the concern is only a minor one, and he could recover in time for Sunday's outing in Merseyside. If he is deemed unfit, there could be a Premier League debut for Altay Bayandır, who joined the club from Fenerbahçe last summer. He made 40 appearances last season. Bayandır has yet to make a competitive appearance for the Red Devils. He could finally get his chance, suppose Onana does not pass the necessary fitness test. United have a tricky period ahead with three successive away games. They travel to Everton before facing Galatasaray and Newcastle United on the road. Mason Mount has perfect chance to cement starting role under Erik ten Hag. Manchester United midfielder Mason Mount has the perfect chance to cement a starting role under manager Erik ten Hag following Christian Eriksen's knee injury. Mount started the first two games of the Premier League campaign for the Red Devils before picking up an unfortunate hamstring injury. He has since struggled to nail down a regular role, and manager Erik ten Hag recently said that he has to fight to regain his starting berth. The Englishman has now received an untimely boost with Eriksen on the sidelines for a few weeks. The Dane picked up a knee problem in the first half against Luton Town, and United have confirmed that he will be out of action for a while. In our view, this could directly benefit Mount, as the manager is likely to prefer his creativity over the defensive resolve of Sofiane Amrabat. Scott McTominay has pretty much earned his spot on the back of Casemiro's injury. Mount has the chance to do the same in the coming weeks. The 24-year-old was a specialist attacking midfielder during his time at Chelsea, but he has been asked to play in the number 8 role for United. Mount has yet to adapt to the transition, but he should get an extended run of starts during the festive period where he could recapture his form. The 60 million euros rated star is currently short in confidence, but we believe he is just one strong performance away from finding his feet. The attacker was one of the best playmakers in the country not so long ago. He has the perfect opportunity to become an undisputed starter at United. Harry Maguire launches a scathing attack on referees. Manchester United defender Harry Maguire has launched a scathing attack on referees in the Premier League and the confusion surrounding what is and isn't a penalty. According to the Mirror, the former United captain has slammed the ridiculous mess surrounding penalties at the moment. Despite experiencing somewhat of a renaissance this season, the England international has had a torrid time of it over the last 2 or 3 years. The defender has become the butt of many jokes, and copious memes and YouTube videos have been released taking pleasure in documenting his all-too-frequent errors, mainly while donning the red of United. Things got so bad that at one point, various pundit, managers and players referred to the treatment Maguire was receiving as bullying and called for it to stop. The abuse led to even the player's own mother feeling she had to release a statement to demand that fans desist from such negativity and that she wished this sort of abuse on nobody. Maguire has now turned his fire on the quality of refereeing and, in particular, their decisions in regard to penalties. There have been numerous contentious decisions this season at home and abroad. Maguire stated that, "For me, penalties in the last 6 months, a year or so, especially in the Premier League, all over the world really, the Champions League, they are given for anything, they are so soft." The man capped 62 times for his country believes that under current circumstances, it's impossible for defenders to defend properly. He exasperates that players should be able to move their body, their arms and make contact. While the United number 5 has a strong point, the defender can certainly be guilty of overindulging in the physical side. In his country's recent game against North Macedonia, the People's Person reported on a comical incident where the defender pulled down a Macedonian player in a rugby-style tackle but somehow avoided a foul being given against him. Nevertheless, his point is still valid. The United player fumed that nowadays penalties are given for everything. He believes that some of the decisions that have been given this season are ridiculous, and the Premier League should lead the way in changing the threshold of what is and is not a penalty kick. Facundo Pellestri impresses for Uruguay in a 3-0 win versus Bolivia. Manchester United winger Facundo Pellestri was impressive for Uruguay during their 3-0 win over Bolivia in a World Cup qualifier last night. The 21-year-old has yet to become a regular starter for the Red Devils under manager Erik ten Hag, but he is considered as one of the first names on the team sheet for his national team. Pellestri started against Bolivia in yesterday's World Cup qualifier, and he had a top showing from the right wing, providing the assist for Darwin Nunez's opening goal in the 15th minute. Over the course of the game, he had 40 touches with a passing accuracy of 88%. He won 4 duels and completed 100% of his dribbles at the Estadio Centenario. Pellestri created 2 big chances and provided 3 key passes. Defensively, he showed the willingness to track back when required and was successful in winning 2 tackles. The youngster is hugely rated by the national team but has yet to receive the same recognition at United. He registered a late assist for Bruno Fernandes' winner against Fulham, but it was not sufficient to convince the manager to play him against Copenhagen or Luton Town. With a hectic schedule coming up, Ten Hag will no doubt want to use the squad depth for rotation. Pellestri needs to take full advantage of any opportunity that comes his way. In our view, Alejandro Garnacho and Marcus Rashford are most likely to start against Everton on the road. The former has started the last 4 games and should be persisted with. If Garnacho fails to make any goal contributions over the next few games, it could open the door for Antony or Pellestri to stake a claim for a starting position out wide. Man United intensifies scouting on João Neves, but Benfica have firm transfer stance. Manchester United have intensified their scouting on Benfica wonderkid João Neves, according to Portuguese publication O Jogo. The 19-year-old is one of the most sought-after young midfielders in European football. Bruno Fernandes recently urged the Red Devils to sign him. It's now reported that United have intensified their observations of the youngster, but a deal could be difficult to pull off, with Benfica reluctant to negotiate. Benfica president is determined to keep hold of the club's prized asset, and he has the ambition to continue with the midfielder beyond the season. United will have to trigger the €120 million release clause in Neves' contract to prize him away. Benfica had a similar stance over Enzo Fernandes last winter. They were reluctant to lose him until Chelsea accepted to pay slightly higher than his €120 million buyout clause. United may need to negotiate an identical deal for a long-term payment plan, but it's unlikely that they will make a move during the January transfer window. The club are currently in a difficult situation with financial fair play, With the lack of investment from the Glazers, they are close to breaching the spending limits. Sir Jim Ratcliffe is prepared to provide funding after securing a minority stake, but it's unlikely that the club will afford Neves unless there are several departures. Neves would be an outstanding acquisition for United at just 19. He is brilliant with his distribution and has won over 2 tackles and 7 duels per game this term. He could be seen as a successor to Casemiro, who has shown signs of slowing down. The club could spend big on him next summer, provided things go their way. We don't see any European outfit making a huge outlay on Neves in January. Chelsea are capable of doing so, but they no longer need to strengthen their midfield. Manchester United will have to pay €30 million for a 24-year-old midfielder target. Manchester United are reportedly keen on signing the French midfielder Youssef Fofana, according to a report via Vigaches. The Red Devils want to sign the 24-year-old defensive midfielder in order to boost their midfield options, and they might have to pay €30 million for the Frenchman. Fofana has been a key player for Monaco since joining the club, and he could prove to be a solid acquisition for the Red Devils. Players like Casemiro have not been able to perform at a high level this season, and Erik ten Hag needs midfield reinforcement. Fofana will add physicality and defensive cover to the Manchester United midfield, and the reported valuation of €30 million seems quite reasonable for a player of his ability. The Frenchman is likely to improve with coaching and experience, and he could develop into a key player for the Red Devils. Improving the midfield unit should be a top priority for Manchester United in the coming months, and Fofana certainly fits the profile. His arrival would not only help protect the central defense, but he would also allow creative players like Mason Mount and Bruno Fernandes to operate with more freedom. Apparently, Manchester United will face competition from Paris Saint-Germain and Juventus. It remains to be seen whether they can win the race for his signature. They are one of the biggest clubs in the world, and the opportunity to move to Old Trafford is likely to be an attractive proposition for the player. As we wrap up today's Manchester United news, remember to stay tuned for daily updates right here on the channel. Don't miss out on the latest updates, so make sure to hit that subscribe button and give us a like if you found this information valuable. Your support means the world to us. Thanks for watching, and until next time, take care.